Dakota Gartner with the Entertainment Institute. We were lucky enough to present a full day of panels at the launch conference today. That's fantastic. Entertainment Institute is a tool for people that are looking to get into the entertainment fields, where they can learn from artists and industry veterans, both in person and online. I mean, we all kind of work together in order to create this, I mean, vision that we dreamed up in a way. We all have specific roles, yes, but it's really all hands on deck as well.
Dakota is the artist liaison, so he works with all of our gurus to get the workshop set up and get them on board, make sure they have everything they need to help educate online. And we're going to have a big activation on the Warped Tour this year, where we have lots of gurus holding workshops at every tour date. So he's been working with all the gurus to get that set up.
Jen overall is the awesome boss lady who just is able to make it so that we're all going in the right direction. You know, she's a teacher at Columbia College, so she really understands how to get this out in the right way. Actually, it is new because we're doing it as the Entertainment Institute, but there were educational classes with our other partner, Matt Halpern, in the form of something called Band Happy. And that ran for about 3 years in a similar format in which people could get lessons with artists either on their instrument or on specific qualities like songwriting, so on and so forth. So this year, our activation is both front of house and backstage. And what we do is we have a 20 by 30 tent front of house that will have smaller workshops that are more like instrument lessons or just smaller groups, you know, 10 to 25 people. And then backstage, we'll have more seminar format workshops that are still dealing with similar topics, you know, whether it be songwriting or music business and so on and so forth, but they're larger formats, so like 50 to 100 people will be in those situations.
I love talking about numbers and math. I'm the tour accountant for the Warped Tour, and as such, one of my main responsibilities is settling the show every day, which means meeting with the promoter and working out how much the tour should be paid for that performance that we're having that show. I love talking about how bands get paid, how festivals get paid, how festivals pay bands. So working through the different deal structures for arts and performance fees, and helping people understand what the different deals are, and then how to properly settle a show and handle all the show finances. That's my favorite.
Well, for me, my favorite thing is to listen to some of our gurus talking about what they are specialists in, right? Like, Jen is so good at numbers. She's so good with the finances, and I am not. I come from a DIY punk rock background, you know? I'm good at speaking on how to book your first tour or how to figure it out, because I'm kind of a kid trying to figure it out, you know? And so I think that, you know, where we all like talking about our specialties, what's really inspiring for us as well is to be able to learn from folks.
It's great.
It's so awesome.
I've been on the Warped Tour for 7 years, so it's been great building that relationship over time, and now that we're working together as partners on the Entertainment Institute, it's wonderful working year-round on something that we both feel passionate about.
Yeah, it's fantastic. You know, Kevin is one of my main mentors in life. I met him for the first time when I was 12 years old, and I've been able to really, you know, obviously get my foot in the door by being an intern in his office and then working on the various things that we work on together now. But overall, Kevin is just a true innovator, and he is one of the kindest human beings I've ever known. Everything.
Patience.
Yes. Okay, the thing that I've been working on a lot lately in my own psyche is how to separate business and emotion, right? And it's something that is so difficult for me right now, and I'm learning every single day how to figure that out, right? So I think for me, I think every person has a difficulty that they have to struggle through, but for me, that's what it is.
I think a lot of people get intimidated by numbers and intimidated by not understanding all the steps in a process. So we're trying to simplify all of that and make present our material in really relatable ways that people can easily understand. And you know, in a conference like this, we don't have time to get into the deep details of all of our topics, but it gives people an idea, a tip of the iceberg, and helps them understand what they should do more research on and what areas they need to learn more about.
And a lot of times it's just starting that initial conversation, right? I mean, I think that's what's really beautiful about the online workshops that we're starting to do right now is that, you know, you have to talk. There's only 8 people in that class, and it's a necessity for you to get your question out. Like, you paid for that course, right? And so I think that that's something that can be really difficult as well. Tell you the truth, or do you want us to give you some type of inflated thing? Skype only allows 10 people in their courses, and what we found is that we wanted to have the guru and then a moderator who would basically keep the flow going and deal with any customer service related. So we are kind of at mercy of Skype's 10-person goal.
But we've also found that it is good size for an online workshop. Everybody has the opportunity to ask their own personal questions and have a personal interaction with the guru, but it's not so overwhelming, so it's not so overwhelmingly large. But 8 people is also, you get to hear lots of other people's questions. So we really found that it's a great size group.
It's awesome.
Well, careers are a journey. Used to be back in, you know, the olden days, maybe you went to college, maybe you didn't, but when you started working, you got a job, and then you stayed at that company until you retired. And obviously our world is not like that anymore, but you know, our industry really benefits for people who have changed jobs and moved around and been exposed to a lot of different elements in the industry. So when I started out, I thought I wanted to be a tour manager. But that what was available to me was working in the accounting office at a local concert promoter. So that was not, I knew that was not what I wanted to do, and I spent that time working on the next thing. So I tell people, always enjoy what you're doing right now, but be working on the next thing and the next step in your career. So after getting out of the accounting office, finally getting a more on-site job, I was a talent buyer, which I kind of knew wasn't going to be for me forever, but it was what was available, and it was a really great experience. But then, of course, there were some elements of that job that I didn't love. So I quit doing that to become a full-time freelance tour accountant, which is all the parts of the talent buying job that I like and then the parts that I don't like. So I was 30 before I ended up in the position that was perfect for me, and that's being a tour accountant. And hindsight now, I would have hated being a tour manager. I never want to be a tour manager. I'm not interested in babysitting adults. I got 2 kids, that's plenty of my own kids, and you know, I am not interested in making sure people show up on time and you know, do everything to take care of them. So being the tour accountant is great because I don't have to do that, and I think that people that are good tour managers really do love this kind of making sure lots of other people are taken care of.
Yeah. I mean, I think that overall, what's interesting about entertainment fields is you kind of just roll into it. For me, you know, I'm 2 years out of college, and so every day I wake up and I'm so excited about the fact that I'm able to experience what I get to experience, you know? Like, I was so, you know, I was interning at Kevin's office and it seemed like it was coming to the end of what I was supposed to be there for, right? And then when I got the opportunity to start booking speaking engagements with him, because that's one of my parts that I, why I'm around at the end of it, right? It kind of all started to click. It just all clicked because something educational was coming of it, and that was something that my values were represented in. And then from there, I mean, you know, with the Entertainment Institute and the ability to meet and work with the people that I have, I'm ready for whatever, you know, life has to throw at me. I may get knocked down for a second, but it's about picking yourself up, brushing yourself off, and figuring it out.
Well, there's a lot of trial and error in finding that right job. And there are, you know, the title of the job, while that's important, what really matters is what you actually spend every minute of your day doing. So do you like sitting at a desk, or do you like being on your feet and walking around all day? Do you like working in a loud environment, or do you prefer a quiet, calm environment? Do you handle stress well in intense situations, or do you need, you know, something a little bit more even keel? Those are all things that kind of need to be taken into account when you're figuring out what you really like or don't like about a job that you're in.
Passion. You just said it. It really is. It's about being passionate about what you're doing. It's not about, for me, it's not about money. It's about literally just being happy and excited.
Yeah, success for me is having a well-rounded, fulfilling life and a career that is enjoyable and something that I love working on is a huge element of that, as is my family life and having some personal time to myself. So success is being, for me, being able to balance all of the things that lead to a fulfilling life.
You know, we have a lot of awesome things that are coming out with the Entertainment Institute, and we hope to make it so that people that are looking to get into the industry have this tool to further their career, their education, and everything in between. And so, whether it be our online workshops or our on-tour workshops or something on the work tour or something at a conference like this, we hope that you can take the reins with that tool and go where you want to go with it.
Yep. Well said.
Thank you.